General Winfield Scott addressed to Cherokee Nation, May 10, 1838. Cherokees, the President of the United States has sent me with a powerful army to cause you, in obedience to the Treaty of 1835, Treaty of Acota, to join that part of your people who have already established, in prosperity, on the other side of the Mississippi. Unhappily, the 2 years which were allowed for the purpose, you have suffered to pass away without following, and without making any preparation to follow. And now, or by the time that this solemn address shall reach your distant settlement, the engagement must be commenced in haste, but I hope without disorder. I have no power, by granting a farther delay, to correct the error that you have committed. The full moon of May is already on the wane, and before another shall have passed away, every Cherokee man, woman, and child in those states must be in motion to join their brethren in the far west. My friends, this is no sudden determination on part of the President, whom you and I must now obey. By the treaty, the emigration was to have been completed on or before the 23rd of this month, and the President has constantly kept you warned during the 2 years allowed, through all his officers and agents in this country, that the treaty would be enforced. I am come to carry out that determination. My troops already occupy many positions in the country that you are to abandon, and thousands are approaching from every quarter, to render resistance and escape alike hopeless. All those troops, regular and militia, are your friends. Receive them and confide in them as such. Obey them when they tell you that you can remain no longer in this country. Soldiers are as kind-hearted as brave, and the desire of every one of us is to execute our painful duty in mercy. We are commanded by the President to act towards you in that spirit, and much is also the wish of the whole American people. Chiefs, headmen, and warriors, will you then, by resistance, compel us to resort to arms? God forbid. Or will you, by flight, seek to hid yourselves in the mountains and forests, and thus oblige us to hunt you down? Remember that in pursuit, it may be impossible to avoid conflicts. The blood of the white man, or the blood of the red man, may be spilt, and if spilt, however, accidentally, it may be impossible for the discreet and humane among you, or among us, to prevent a general war and carnage. Think of this, my Cherokee brethren. I am an old warrior, and I have been present at many a scene of slaughter. But spare me, I beseech you, the horror of witnessing the destruction of the Cherokees. Do not, I invite you, even wait for the close approach of the troops, but make such preparations for emigrations as you can, and hasten to this place, to Ross's Landing or Gunter's Landing, where you will be received in kindness by officers selected for the purpose. You will find food for all and clothing for the destitute at either of those places, and thence at your ease and in comfort be transported to your new homes according to the terms of the treaty. This is the address of a warrior to warriors. May his entreaties be kindly received, and may the God of both prosper the Americans and Cherokees, and preserve them long in peace and in friendship with each other.